Hello dear subscribers, hello dear viewers without subscription, welcome wherever you are, whenever you watch this. My name is Ines and I'm coming to you from Germany. And today I'm going to start with my weaving project. I will not talk a lot about it, I will just show it to you because I'm not happy with it, I don't know what I will make with it, and you will see that it is an exercise piece that I'm not very good at weaving, but well, you have to try it out to know what you can do. So it starts here. And it's all ice yarn. I wanted to get rid of some of my ice yarn. This is very like a carpet. And then I realized that it was me who made it that strong and stiff. So I changed my tension and here you can see the pattern, and then I forgot that I wanted to put stripes in it, and yeah, just took the colors as they came. Here's the blue one, then I have a little brown spot, it's not long, and in the end there is this nice red yarn. If I had known that this red yarn is so soft and sheeny and I don't know what else, I like this red one really well, I would have made the whole shawl with it, but I didn't know and I just took it out in the end when I was at the end of the other yarn. And you see that's the end. I haven't secured the end yet, I need to do that and then decide what I want to make from it. It was supposed to be a shawl, I don't know if it will be one. By now I just put it back into my shelf and yeah, whenever the time comes that I want to do something with it, I will, and then I will tell you. But at the moment I just wanted to present it as one of my finished projects because I didn't do much else. I was sitting at my loom for hours and hours and hours to finish this thing. I finished it and now I'm not very fond of it, but maybe after washing and what else I can do, I will like it more. Okay, next topic. Our spinning group made a trip to an alpaca farm. That was funny. I will put photos of the alpaca somewhere here. They have like 40, more than 40 alpacas there, and they have a wool mill. It was really interesting to see how they process the wool from the alpacas, and not only alpacas, they get yarn from all over Germany or all over the world, I have forgotten. So they have a lot of yarn that they have to make into, no, not yarn, wool, the raw wool, the fibers that they have to make into yarn. And I mean, when you are there, how can you go away without buying some of the alpaca fibers? These are 500 grams of alpaca after it comes out of the carding machine. And you see the different colors. They say that they have 22 different colors there. I'm not sure if I have 22 different colors in here, but yeah. I don't know what to make with it. I will make yarn, but I don't know how I will do it, if I will take it from the top and then just spin and spin and spin until the bag is empty. I have no idea. I haven't started thinking about it yet. It's a nice feeling to have that much alpaca fiber to work with, but yeah, I'm not in the right mood of thinking about it. And talking of spinning, the same day when we went to the alpaca farm, we also went to a spinning wheel maker. I don't know if you know those spinning wheels, it's Henkies. And I don't know why I talk about Henkies. Oh, I might start with Sleeping Beauty, because Henkies is producing the Sleeping Beauty, yeah, I don't know what it is called. You can put it on your hankies and you have this, yeah, I don't know, this part of the spinning wheel. It's not like you are working with a spindle, it's a little bit different because it doesn't wind the yarn. You just spin and then you have to wind and then you spin again and then you wind. But And this is actually for a friend of mine because I do not have a hankies, and she wanted to have it because when she is on markets and such, she gets asked a lot of times which part of the spinning wheel is the part that Sleeping Beauty touched and fell asleep, and this is it. And I learned about Sleeping Beauty that it must come from French. French culture, French tradition, at least this is what Mr. Henkes told us, and that the hand spinners were against the invention of this pre-spinning wheel thingy, and so they invented a lot of stories how dangerous it is and what can happen, and that's how Sleeping Beauty got started. Interesting, isn't it? So, spinning. I may or may not have told you that I wanted to buy the great jumbo flyer for my minstrel spinning wheel. Minstrel is a spinning wheel by Kromski. And just to compare, this is the normal flyer that you get with the spinning wheel when you buy a Kromski minstrel. And this is the great jumbo flyer. Isn't that cute? I mean, like father and son or something. this spool can hold 120 gram of yarn, and this one holds 700 gram. So, yeah, I'm excited about having this one, and I have already started making yarn with it. It's, yeah, I do not use the... I don't know what it is called, the break for the spool. Is it called the break for the spool? But the two thread, you know, system. And it's a difference because I'm not used to it, but I like it. And this is the yarn I made. This is a Navajo plied. And yeah, it's almost balanced, though it didn't seem to be balanced when it came from the spinning wheel. And because I wasn't used to the two thread turning thingy, I'm having problems finding my words today. Maybe I shouldn't make the video today, but I hope if you are a spinner, you will know what I mean. If you are not, it doesn't matter because it's not that interesting. It's just something that I have problems with. So this is the yarn that I made. It took one afternoon and I don't know what to do with it. I still have a lot of my own yarns, and I started after we came back from the alpaca farm. I wanted to use up some of my hand spun alpaca, which I can show you here. I actually made a little crochet yeah, I don't know what it is. Maybe it's like a bracelet. You can put it around your arm. And I think in crochet, you don't see that it is really a thick and thin yarn, and yeah, not very consistent. But when you knit, and I started knitting with it as well, of course, you will see all the, yeah, the parts where it's not especially consistent and not especially nice. So, and I had forgot that when I started making or spinning the alpaca, that I made a really, really thick kind of yarn. And in the end, when I used my drop spinner, I was better, and the thread became more consistent but thinner. So I started with the thin yarn and then changed to the thicker yarn. Yeah, don't like this at all. I think I will make hats with it, crochet hats, so that you don't see all the parts that are not so nice. Yeah, but this is what you can make with your hand spun. Just you see that I really try to work with the yarn that I have. Okay, then I told you that I am a member of the Knit Crate community. The February box took, I don't know, it came here in March because it had to go through customs, and then they notified me that I could get it in, I don't know, I had to drive like 1 hour to get there, and I did not need to pay anything, but I'm afraid that this will happen again, that I have to go there like once every 2 months to get my knit crate. But anyways, I made the project of February, and you may have seen unboxing of knit crate already with the yarn, and this is what I made. It's the knitting project. It's a, yeah, interestingly shaped shawl or scarf or whatever you will call this. And I like this pattern very much. And the first time that I made a picot binding, bind off. So this is the knit crate of February. And this is something that I only realized like, yeah, 2 or 3 days ago. I like to watch yarn hauls. And since I'm making my knit crate videos where I unbox the yarn, where I show the pattern, where I show the yarn after I wound it into a ball, and where I also show the finished product or project, I've realized that this is something that I would really like to see more often. So, for instance, I watched a video where they bought like chenille or bouclé yarn, and I don't use these yarns. I would like to see a finished project with them. So this is something that I'm working on for my German videos, that when I buy yarn for a special project, I will make a video about the project only. So when I get the yarn, I will record the unboxing and will show the yarn, and then I will make the next video when I have started the project, when you can already see something, and yeah, all in one video, so that when I talk about the yarn, I can also show a finished product. Because yeah, sometimes this seems to be missing from videos, I think. Not always. I also like watching people just unboxing their yarn, like the 45 kilogram of ice yarn from the Secret Yarnery. That was a funny video. I like that very much. And yeah, there we are. I bought yarn, and I will show you just this one bag. This is all yarn from Hobby. I think it's a Danish company. I don't know. I get it from their German subsidiary. I don't know. They must have a place in Germany where they sell the yarn as well. This yarn is their rainbow yarn. It's 100% cotton and it's organic yarn. I have not done the research what it means when they tell you it's organic or biologically grown. Yeah, but this was one of the points why I bought this. I bought 45 balls in different colors. Here you have green and blue and sort of lavender or purple and another blue and pink. I do have pink as well. And I am making a Tunisian crochet blanket. And don't run away while I try to put the balls back into the bag. Back into the bag. Okay, so I have another bag of the yellows and cream and whatever, but you will see it in the project in a second. I am making the blanket that you see here. And maybe there's another better picture of the blanket. So this is the blanket that I'm making, and I have already started, and I have already finished all the 14 all 14 colors once, because you work in stripes and you use all the colors. And I hope that I don't lose everything here. This is what I have so far. So I started with the dark blue, then the green, and the, oh yeah, I don't know, is it peach or something? And It's not only the different colors, it's also the different patterns that you make. So I have these stars and these, I don't know, what are they called? The popcorn stitch, something. Yeah, so, and the waves and the original Tunisian stitch. So this is something that I'm working on at the moment. Will take a while. I have like my bit, little bit longer than my wingspan, do you say that? And I don't know how long it will be, but I'm looking forward to making this. And each row is fun because of the colors and because of the pattern. So this is something that I'm trying to put into one video for my German viewers on my German channel. I've already started showing the yarn, and I have shown the project after I had finished the 14 colors. Yeah, and that's almost everything that I'm working on. I'm missing something. Oh, it's behind me. I told you about Knit Crate. And the March Knit Crate came with a fantastic yarn. And I just, like 10 minutes or before I started recording, I finished the project. I made the crochet project. And it's the first where I am at the end of the yarn, but not at the end of the pattern. So I couldn't make the etching. And I do have like a little bit more, like a little bit more than a meter left, but it's not enough to put it into the next row. So yeah, I could have made the etching after the, but I didn't realize that it wouldn't be enough. Doesn't matter, the yarn is fantastic. It's silk, cashmere and merino yarn. It's in the Titmouse colorway and I like it very much. I haven't washed it yet. I will wash it and block it, and it's one of my favorite, most favorite projects that I have ever made. Every row I was wondering about the colors, how they turned up, and I'm so happy that Knit Crate doesn't have the yarn yet in their shop, because that was the first thing that I did, look if I can buy more. And yeah, I hope that I will have forgotten it when it turns up in the shop that I wanted to buy it, because this will be quite expensive. I think more than $30 for 100 gram, but it is something special. Yeah, and then I still have one work in progress, which is made from, where's my ball band? I put it here, no, it's gone. Okay, but I know it's hobby yarn, Peruvian, Highland wool, 100% wool. And this, okay, I made a swatch. And I have like two stitches and one row more than is required. So, but this will be a mitten project, and I have just started it. This will be the upper part. It's not finished. I need like 11 more rows, and it's an interesting pattern. It folds like these, what are they called? These, you know what the women used when they were hot? Fan? Is it a fan? I don't know, but it looks a little bit like one. And this will be a color work project. I have the Peruvian Highland yarn from Hobby in four different colors, and I'm not in the right mood of making mittens right now. That's why this is lying about, and I'm rather working at my blanket. But this will be something that will come up again in one of the next videos. And I hope that I will have finished it by the beginning of the next winter, of winter 2019. So in the end of the year. And yeah, that's everything that I can tell you today. I hope you enjoyed my little projects and the things that I'm doing. And please let me know if you would be interested in such a video that I mentioned before, so that I show you the yarn. I bought this for this project. And then putting the video together, the yarn, here are the beginnings, that is what I have so far, and here's the finished product, and everything edited into one video so that you can see it from purchasing, purchasing. It sounds funny. Until the finished object, then I will try to do it in English as well, because when I start recording in German, I can do it in English as well. So I might do these videos for you as well. I'm not doing it for Knit Crate because there are so many Knit Crate videos out in the world already that I didn't think that I would have to do it for my English viewers. But in Germany, it's not very popular, or it's not known that you can have something like that. And that's why I'm doing a monthly video about Knit Crate. But if you would be interested in that as well, I can do that for you, I think. Okay, today I'm not the best English speaker, but who cares? You see, I started this whole project in English to get better in English, or to lose my anxiety, or whatever it was that held me back talking English a little more. And now I'm stuttering about, and I don't even care. I will not edit out any of my bloopers and blunders. I will just leave them in. And yeah, I'm feeling more comfortable with this whole project. Thank you, David from the DocDare podcast, for initializing this dare along. I'm really glad you did, because I feel much more at ease sitting here talking to my webcam in a language that's not my own. So, but now I have talked enough. We will meet again. I mean, you will see my video in April, and maybe if you tell me you are interested in something like I proposed earlier, maybe one video in between. And until then,